In this video, we learn how to model hyperlasting material property in Abaqus. First, we use very simple cylindrical structure with radius 1 meter and length 1 meter. For boundary condition, the bottom surface of cylinder is fixed and tensile pressure load is applied to the top surface. And for hyperelastic material property, the stress-strain curve was simply fitted with six-point data. When it comes to hyperelasticity, in general, it can be thought of as material property of rubber or rubber-like material. The hyperelastic is nonlinear elastic without plastic behavior, and it has large deformation and nonlinear stress strain curve. That is, generally, elastic is used for small deformation case, such as 1% or a few percent deformation. On the other hand, hyperelastic is used for really large deformation. It can be 100% or a few 100% deformation. The nonlinear stress strain curve means for metal material, stress strain curve show almost straight line in elastic region, but hyperelastic material, this stress strain curve shows nonlinear curve. The stress strain curve of hyperelastic material property is mathematically derived from strain energy potential. In Abaqus, we used Marlowe model for hyperelastic material. The potential function of Marlowe model is like this. One more thing. In general, rubber is almost incompressible material. That is, if we apply tensile load in one direction, it is compressed in other directions. And if we apply compressive load, it is stretched out in other direction. Eventually, the entire volume becomes constant during this deformation. The rubber has such an incompressibility. Okay. Now let's select and evaluate the hyperelastic material. Select the material added and hyperelastic, and material type is isotropic, and strain energy potential is Marlowe. Then click the test data and copy and paste test data in the Excel sheet like this. Actually, these values correspond to uniaxial data. Before the next step, we have to check whether our selected material model is right for the test data. That is, run material evaluation. For the material evaluation, I just selected three models. Polynomial, the Ogden, the Marlowe. We can see that the all models came out stable, right? Stable, stable, stable. And curve fittings with its parametric data looks very good. That's why the Marlowe model is the first good choice for our problem. Well, which one is best for our structural problem? Simply put, when the only one type of test data is given, then Marlowe is the first recommended and good material model. So basically, we can try first. Polynomial is for a limited test data, particularly when if we have various type of test data, for example, at least uniaxial and equal by actual test data, then we can use Ogden for these extensive test data. Generally, there are four material test methods. The first, uniaxial test data. Second, biaxial test data. Third, planar test data. Fourth, volumetric test data. Uniaxial test data is simply measured from deformation in one direction. And biaxial tester is from deformation in both directions. Planar test data is what we got in a plane straight. The last one, volumetric test data, is to measure compressive deformation. When all these test data are available, it will be effective to use Ogden model. But when only one test data is a given, it will be better to use a Marlowe model first and probably try the polynomial model in addition. Okay, now let's go over Abacus modeling. I will show you how to model in Abacus. Thank you. Thank you.